Some bombs never go off, some stars never blow up. I'm pitching in, never in the dugout. Reaching in my and I can't take a head count. Flashback, oh, three things was looking run down. Now I set foot in the place, it's a luau. Killing like 10 counts, y'all know how we get down. House with the fence around, y'all know that we in route. Transition from the Impala to the Fisker. I should charge admission for that to get the dessert. Left the doors up, now the Lambo has pigtails. Since you getting comfy, I'ma let you sit there. I'ma let you stay there. When I shed a tear, they didn't have no care. So I'ma charge retail. I brought some, cause you say you want sick. If you love sick in the room, you best get well. Every dog has his day. What the no tuck? Sway Lee Winter Magazine, double XL. Floss with your Gucci on. Dipped in colors burst on the cars and the jewels.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a matchup where time of possession will be a focus. The Saints are top 10 in rushing yards, going up against the Redskins front seven that will need to be up to the test.
Thank you. We are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Washington Redskins. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. That's fielded in the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. They're led out by their 6-foot quarterback. You may have heard of him. From Purdue, it's Drew Brees.
His numbers sometimes are just absolutely staggering because last year, threw for the fourth highest total in NFL history, 5,208 yards. Okay, now if you look in the record books, here's the number that he occupies in single-season passing. Second, fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth, and 11th best single seasons in NFL history. That's crazy.
Yeah, you said staggering when you started talking, and I'm going to finish it with staggering. What a career it's been, and it continues for Mr. Brees. I think defensively, you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Now Brees on third down. And this is going to be incomplete.
Now that's a great opening series defensively. You force what should be a three and out on your opening possession.
And great coverage there on third down to force the incompletion to set up fourth. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Turn that time, 18 yards, and possession will switch hands, first and 10. Oh, first carry for Samaje Perine. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. So that one will get him halfway to the first down marker. 7 yards, makes it third and seven now.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is... Three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
I don't care who you put on him. He's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
And it's caught, Kobe Flaner. And he's brought down after a good gain. A nice gain of 21 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that player action there that sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
On second down, here's Breeze. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. From the gun on third down, Breeze. And that is incomplete.
It's a great job by... ball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And he'll give it here to his running back. Big hold to the 30. He's got the lane, and there he goes. 20, 10, and he takes it down deep into enemy territory. Big yardage that time for the Redskins. 78 yards. Here's Smith, eluding the pressure right, and they're going to get to him, a sack, back at the 9-yard line.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
On second down, here's Smith, and it's caught. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Josh Doctson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins have taken a first quarter lead.
That drive was quick and impressive, almost like they had somewhere else they needed to be after the game.
Here's Franks now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. A look there at Ingram's numbers from a week ago. 22 carries, 99 yards.
Well, this is where it becomes a challenge for the offensive coordinator. He's got a bell cow at tailback right now, number 3 in the league in rushing, within shouting distance of the lead. But at the same time, if the passing game is open, he's got to take advantage of that, too.
They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But...
And 3 full yards here for the offense to get on 3rd down. They'll try to run for the first with Ingram. Oh, and they had him stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker. Looked like a clear face mask to me.
Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
On 1st down, Breeze setting up the receiver screen here to Thomas. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Give him 9 there on the 1st down completion. On 2nd down, Ingram. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. The Saints on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. It's complete to Flanner. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. Breeze finding Flanner for New Orleans first.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you can actually be pushed back before the 1st down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the 1st down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the 1st down completion.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Mason Foster in there to drop him for his 5th sack of the year. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
Breeze to another longtime vet, Ginn, for the New Orleans first.
Well, we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Show some confidence, supreme confidence. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Zach Brown not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
His throw caught at about the 5. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Corey Brown. His 5th touchdown now on the year. Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. While we have a minute, we remind you that later tonight we'll have a couple of NFC East rivals squaring off, the Eagles and the Cowboys from Big D.
Or Arlington. Got to make sure we get it right.
To be more precise there in the Metroplex. Then tomorrow night, week 11, we'll wrap up with a playoff rematch from the divisional round a year ago, the Falcons and Seahawks, but this time from Seattle. And on 2nd and 10 now. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He'll wind up losing 3. And now it's 3rd down. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Now Smith. Jordan Reed has it. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown. Washington. Jordan Reed, his 3rd touchdown now on the year, and the Redskins have taken the lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call, but he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers, or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Here's Franks now to kick this one away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and 11. He came out ready to play. That's 3 tackles for a loss, Charles. We're only in the 2nd quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing. And is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
That's good for 21 yards and a 1st down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think it'll help set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Caught on the left side by Ginn. Take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Ted Ginn, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Coming into the year, Brees, 465 touchdown passes, add another one to the total.
You know, it's funny, I just talked with his college head coach, and he told me that when Drew was a sophomore at Purdue, they weren't sure he was truly the starter, even though he started the opening game, and he made a play early in that one. But the coach got on the headset and told the rest of the staff, well, fellas, we found our quarterback. Now we got to make sure we find the rest of our team.
Brees hasn't looked back since. A reminder with halftime approaching, when we get there, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have 1st half highlights and analysis.
And I hope he's iced down his throat because he's got a lot to get through because we've had no shortage of points scored in the 1st half.
It has been a fun track meet. Oh, so close to an interception. Read that beautifully. Got his hands on it. Couldn't get it. And it's 2nd down. So incomplete on 1st. Let's see what 2nd down has in store. Now a play fake, and it's Smith. Trying to lay one up deep. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
To throw is Smith. He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. It's a big play there for the Redskins on third down. And even 50 yards.
There's obviously nothing shy about the guys dialing up offense here. They take a shot on third down, and boy, did they get rewarded, even though there was good defense on the play.
From the red zone now, Smith. His throw incomplete.
Granted, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Off of play action, here's Smith. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. So that's the rookie's first trip to the end zone, and I think it's safe to say one he'll always remember.
Oh, without a doubt. That one is going to be imprinted forever. And nowadays, we're seeing rookies make a greater impact at that position at receiver than ever before. I think mainly because of the sheer volume of footballs.
Franks to add the PAT. To the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
I was going to ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hole, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Breeze now on first down. The catch made over the middle by Ginn. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there. Now Breeze throwing on second down. Throwing the out route incomplete.
Teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Left side and caught by Flaner. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Breeze looking to throw on 3rd and 2. On the check down, he finds Kamara. Down is Breeze. Wide open receiver complete. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A nice gain of 21 yards. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
So we have come upon halftime, and it's the visiting Redskins who have the lead here as we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, back to you guys in a minute. But first, it's indeed time for our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Saints are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost. The Redskins will want to come out after the half and really put the pressure on from the start. So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. Midway through the second quarter, here the catch is made way downfield, and it leads to a touchdown. Saints tie it up at 7.
And we've seemingly lost communication with Larry. Back on the field and ready for the third quarter. This fielded at the 2. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now we'll get our first update of the afternoon for the Meadowlands. And the Chiefs have jumped out to an early lead in their ball game. Patrick Mahomes, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. A gain of 3, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
They'll run again with Piran. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. And that little deke, the juke move that we saw, able to give him the first down yardage before he's brought down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Here's Piran. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
He's got Quinn. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And a short pickup there, down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there, second and goal.
Now that was a good job by the defense swarming to the football. And you know it's no cinch that you're going to be able to get the ball into the end zone against them. They're number 2 against the run. So what's an offensive coordinator to do? Check your playlist.
It'll be a gain of 4, but it'll bring us now to a third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up 3rd.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
The gain of 5 that time gives them the conversion and makes it 1st and goal.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. A good, sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice two-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
And that'll be incomplete. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Again, it's Kamara. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a third and eight situation. Not the start to the drive they were looking for. That run doesn't do much at all.
No, not at all, and it leaves them with third and long. And, you know, this is the time of game where these drives really, really start to matter. They've got to make some moves.
He gets it to Brown. Complete. The 20. 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. Corey Brown with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Saints have cut it back within a score.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. On first down, it's Smith. Crowder's got it over the middle. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight. To throw on second down is Smith. Completes it right side to Doxson. That goes for a gain of 31. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Goddens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Back now here live in New Orleans. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Play action. It's Smith. Rolling to his left. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Throwing on third down, Smith. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively a backbreaker. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. They'll fake it. Now Smith steps away to his left. And some space here. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. And he'll give it here to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3 yard gain brings up a third down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's first and goal. The carry here for the big tight end. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A pickup of four on first down. It'll be second and goal.
Hey, back up.
Second and goal from the 2 yard line. And he gets halfway there down to the 1 yard line. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
Here we go, third and one. Gut check time on both sides. They come up in an offset eye. Now it's Smith. And this is going to be incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit. Too hard about that play selection.
So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. First play of the drive in their hip pocket. Of course, the focus here has to be the touchdown of the two-point conversion. Field goals aren't going to help you.
Yeah, but how about that first play of the drive? Just to get them started, nice game, got some positive momentum going. They're on their way, and they don't have to rush.
It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. All the yards. The feather in the cap of the great career of Drew Brees.
And wasn't he supposed to be too small to be an effective quarterback in the NFL?
Yeah, how'd that work out?
Yeah, well, his footwork, I think, really sets him apart. Remember, he was a junior tennis champion. Beat Andy Roddick, the future U.S. Open champion, back when they were in the juniors. I think that footwork really helps him be the great quarterback he is now.
Give him 30 yards there.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, That'll drive the team towards a victory.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A good pickup there of 22. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Now you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Back to throw. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal. He's back to throw. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas with touchdown number 7 on the year. A big spot now for the Saints as they'll indeed go for 2. They'll look to throw, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And a failure to convert and tie the game. Now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down 1. What's the sense? I like what they did.
A tough one there. They certainly wanted that when they needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have 3 timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it. But even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with 3 timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And the offense will be looking to get at least some of this yardage back here. It's 2nd and 12. Going to give this time to the tailback. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. The Redskins on 3rd down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. This is 3rd and 14. Now Smith. Got a man open. It's Brian Quick. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. The Redskins, they can smell victory now. They take a knee. Down to a knee, here goes Smith, and that should all but do it. Well, I know it points to this when you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones...